So I know we haven't talked a whole lot to Philip.
Nope.
I don't think that's fair to Philip.
This is a problem.
He's been kind of fucky.
Where is it?
So Philip forgot to take his drugs.
Yep.
Tell me, where did she go?
Like I said, sir, she's not aboard this flight.
That's impossible. I talked to her. And...
And what, sir?
And she Olivia talked back.
Yeah, she did. She thought I was a stowaway. I probably shouldn't have revealed that information.
Where'd she stow that gun?
That's a good question.
She pointed a gun at me. Are you saying I was seeing
while
things?
I was choking a man.
I think you must.
Yes.
Maybe it was a pepper shaker.
I don't think so.
On board this flight, there is absolutely no way she would be able to get a gun on board as well.
Unless she hit it in the burgers.
Oh, all those goddamn burgers.
They're all just guns.
Perhaps the shock of lightning has caused you to be
Wait, that means
confused.
David's been eating a whole bunch of guns.
He's, yeah. Mm-hmm. That
right.
Bullet in his head is really making him do some strange things.
Maybe that's why he knows it's a Glock 26.
I guess. It tastes right.
It does. It feels right.
It's part of his lead-filled
that's
diet.
That's not really what I meant.
So he's missing the airplane manual.
Are you
for his
for
blanket
something?
Toolbox
not
drugs?
At all, Mr. Young.
Yes.
I am completely at your disposal.
He's missing something a lot more innocuous.
Yes, yes, of course.
Are you telling me the truth? It looks like you're so busy searching that you haven't done anything yet. I'll find what you're looking for. You just contact the ground.
Is that a threat? Like I'm going to knock you out and you're going to contact the ground?
Very well.
Yes.
I have lost a glove.
A glove? And it has to be this specific one?
Yes.
He only lost one glove.
Perfectly.
Like, it's not like he lost a bunch and he's like, I need this one.
Without it.
Yeah, it's got to be the specific one that goes with the other one he has.
Why is he getting so upset about a glove? He's more high-strung than he looks.
He looks pretty high-strung. What do you... David!
He's an idiot.
You were a detective at some point.
Alright.
Okay, we're just gonna leave it. Okay.
That's... Oh, it's a burned glove?
I think it's supposed to have gotten charred in the lightning accident.
Okay. Gotcha.
Really? This is a problem.
This is a really problem.
Yes.
I found the glove. It's all burnt up, though.
Ah, that's how I left it.
I put it in the microwave.
That's okay, is it?
I thought it was a burger.
No problem. I don't want to use it.
You don't? So, what's going on?
I'm going
Nothing
to eat it.
Nothing concerns you, Mr. Young. This is my problem. Simply recovering the glove was the most important thing.
Huh? What does he want with a glove that can't even be used?
I mean, it could probably still be used.
Just being high strung.
He doesn't use it, though.
I need to probe a bit deeper here.
It's fair.
That's that extra case.
Grid frog set.
I believe that's what we had, Teddy. Wearing in the first food cutscene of this
okay.
episode.
It's possible to manually switch over to door mode, but just touching the controls to do so causes an alarm to sound in the cockpit. You would be better off not to get any silly ideas, sir.
Or I'll have to make you contact your
broken?
Dad.
Not my dad.
What are you planning?
I'm just trying to figure out the method of escape used by Olivia and the vanishing man.
David, that's a thing you're supposed to think, not say.
Yeah, that is not a talk bubble, David.
How many emergency exits are there?
How much
Enough.
Do you know about the federal aviation regulations?
Not a lot.
The FARs.
They are the safety regulations as set by the Federal Aviation Administration.
Oh, is that the Boston FAR?
A commercial aircraft must have enough emergency exits that all passengers can exit the aircraft within 90 seconds while only using half of them.
So they could exit in 45 seconds using all of them?
No, they could use 14 of them to exit in 3 seconds faster than twice the amount of passengers that the plane could have carried yesterday.
Oh, clear math. Okay, perfect.
Yeah, mathematics ain't your strong with suit crew, these either. Aircraft can
carry almost and apparently English isn't yours.
Let's say 30 people can escape from one exit in 90 seconds.
Oh, fuck. That would is there going to be a quiz?
Oh, no. Seconds.
Dividing 140 by 30 therefore indicates that at least 4.6 exits would be needed. Now, twice that are required by the regulations, which means the required number of exits is 9 or more.
Damn, that means I was going to go with 0. And
your lack of math skills. You were close. To escape, sir. Oh, he's just insulting you left and right. Look at that smirk.
Could you escape by opening the windows in the cockpit?
The cockpit windows do not open.
So that's a no. As smart
as you look. You could have just said no, you dick.
Indeed, the construction of the seat and cockpit windows is very different. While the seat windows are 3 layers of polycarbonate resin, the cockpit windows are 5 layers of reinforced glass and polycarbonate resin. Seat windows are 14 millimeters.
Oh my god.
The ones in the cockpit
Jesus.
Are 45 millimeters. Passenger windows are designed to withstand.
Are you an aircraft engineer?
But the cockpit windows have to be able to withstand.
I thought you were going to say the word encyclopedia.
Open windows
like that. Because that would have been really prescient because please. They're going to say the word encyclopedic.
Oh, damn it.
Extra case time.
You know quite a bit about this airplane, don't you?
It's only natural. Our passengers' safety may rely on it.
Natural? I'm not sure.
Airplanes aren't natural.
Describe your encyclopedic knowledge.
Far from it.
And I'm not sure I'd use the word encyclopedic.
More like dictionary graphic.
Yes.
Even you could easily attain it, Mr. Young.
Easily?
Yes, very easily.
How?
Oh,
why,
no.
By taking a quiz.
Remember a couple of weeks ago when I gave you a seemingly random amount of questions?
Yes.
And they had to do with airplanes?
Yes.
Let's see your results.
Oh, no.
Looks like I stepped on a landmine.
As long as I passed. Some
simple questions. We'll have to see. All you I did manage to give you a full grade report at the end.
Oh, fantastic. Answers to pass.
So I'll be answering all these correctly because, I mean, I know the answers. I'm not a fucking moron. But I will be putting your results along with it. So maybe, you know, jet fuel shouldn't be made of something as volatile as nitroglycerin, but that's what you went with.
They use it in heart medicine, okay?
Well, it's not a fucking airplane.
Kerosene doesn't freeze at low temperatures and gives off no soot. That makes
and the best part is that every time you get one wrong, he's going to explain it, and next then you're going to look like a dumb-dumb. Question. How many parachutes but everyone you get right, he's going to explain it and make you look like not a dumb-dumb, so I mean, whatever.
Perfect.
And yes, this is, like, I recorded this before I got your answers, so I tried to play with which one you think I might choose. With a parachute would
do them no favors. If something should happen, don't think about jumping out. I would instead recommend adopting the brace position. Next, the last question at the beginner level. Your luck
you're one for two.
Oh boy.
On the beginner level.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you didn't say dreams.
I should have said dreams. I also want to defend my point. I didn't hear tires. I heard something else. Or just didn't hear tires.
No,
so I just assumed.
Do you think they just fill the entire airplane with oxygen?
Yes.
Who breathes oxygen? You need to fill it with dreams, man.
Nitrogen is therefore the perfect choice when it comes to landing.
So you're not off to the best of starts.
Nope, not at all.
Ignore this part. He's praising me right now, not you.
Yeah.
Stupid.
How am I supposed to know about planes?
You've however, been that's all this was. In a plane.
In a plane. That's next your answer for that.
Yeah.
We'll get started as soon as you are ready.
Next time I'll ask my steward.
Your personal like steward?
All these questions. Yes, all these questions.
No, please don't ask. We've seen what a person asking the flight crew looks like. Ready for the asking the weirdest questions. Don't do that.
The intermediate level needs 5 correct answers to pass. Question: how can you tell at a glance if an airplane carries passengers or cargo?
Number of wings.
Yes,
there's gotta 15 be it. Wings on a cargo plane.
That is correct.
All in a circle.
Yeah, around the middle.
A cargo
yep.
plane.
They have to retract to land.
There are exactly.
No passengers to look out of them, after all. Getting rid of the windows also makes the aircraft lighter. And also increases the strength of the body, like for military aircraft. Even something like a single window makes a big difference to an aircraft.
I mean, now if you add a window, it decreases the strength, so like their biceps aren't as good.
Right, well, of course.
Can't do squats anymore. So this one, I expected you to get a little tripped up on, because these 3 answers are kind of all legit.
Yeah.
That is correct. At high altitude, there is a large gap between inside and outside temperatures.
Inside is about 43,000 degrees centigrade. Outside, it's roughly 2.
If that water rusted or froze,
that is quite a
roughly,
difference.
Okay, there is margin of error.
That's apparently a large margin of error.
It's kept very dry to keep the aircraft safe.
I prefer to say a marge largin.
Question 3.
That is question also correct.
What do the pilot and co-pilot have prepared for them separately?
Blind dates.
I like the toilet.
You know, you don't want to go on the same blind date as your co-pilot.
No, that would be awkward.
That is correct. It prevents both of them suffering from food poisoning. Everyone has heard that, though, haven't they? However, what about on the ground? Did you
then
know
they have
they
different
eat
toilets.
Different meals before they even take off? Always think of the worst possible
just
scenario.
Just so they don't get herpes from the same toilet seat.
Or the same food poisoning.
We are true professionals.
Now, the same toilet from the same question. Food poisoning.
Right, that makes sense.
Why are the internal lights turned off when landing at
to
night?
Please the vampire people, I know this one.
To prevent hijacking when you're landing.
Yeah, I mean, you don't want to land quicker.
Correct. To get the passengers' eyes accustomed to the dark in case something happens. I might also point out that this is also one of the 90-second rules.
What about the 5-second rule?
Final question.
that's something
level.
Different.
Can I claim dropsies?
You are doing quite well. Question. Where are airlines legally obliged to place ashtrays on board?
In the cup holder.
Yeah. I got them all right. All right.
That is correct.
I mean, I failed course, the first part, which is sad, black. But
yeah. This is only the second of 3 parts of the quiz, so you know, buckle up because we're about to experience
so,
some turbulence.
Even though they aren't allowed to be used,
oh, brilliant.
Must have ashtrays. What's more, these regulations were also stipulated by the Federal Aviation Administration.
Even though smoking's not allowed.
Well, I mean, you don't want to fire on the airplane.
Right.
That's why you bring a gun.
Exactly. Tiger set.
What cat-related thing, not thing, person, could we give that to?
I don't. Is it Teddy?
We'll start as soon
no.
As you are ready,
oh.
Sir.
Surprisingly, he doesn't get any bear-themed so next anything.
That would be fantastic.
I saw this coming.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. The
what ladies?
Olivia?
Requires no less.
She's hiding in the microwave.
That makes sense, along
however,
with the burger.
I'm also adding a new rule. You must answer each question within 5 seconds.
God,
it's actually a lot more time than you think.
Who first succeeded in powered manned flight?
It's the Fly family.
Correct.
I'm surprised you got that one.
Bicycles.
Really?
You could have gone with the Left Sisters.
The Left Sisters is fantastic.
I believe we call it the piss box.
Correct. It is attached.
That's
the
toilet.
Question.
Oh yeah, I always confuse
the
two.
Right side of the cockpit.
Is that why they get mad when I start peeing on the back of the plane?
That's exactly right. All right.
Correct.
That well one done. I wasn't so sure about.
The seat on the left side of the cockpit is always the captain's. Question, what is the highest passenger class?
Gorgeous class.
420. I mean, typically.
Yeah, that would make sense. The mile high class.
Correct.
Hey, that's a good joke.
Maybe you'll sit there yourself one day. Unlikely, but maybe. Question, when a bird crashes into an aircraft, it is known as a bird what?
He just gave us the answer. It's called a bird what?
Yes, correct. In fact, that is the name
the birds watch.
Any incident of a bird.
Yeah, it lets them know what time they crashed.
What is the name of the president's jet?
The advanced level were the more common answers than the beginner's level.
I feel like if you're not an American, this question might be difficult.
Correct.
But it's also really common knowledge.
Right.
Question. What is the name given to
it's also the name of a movie.
An aircraft up
no,
and down.
No. That's called Ground Force 2. You're thinking of the sequel to the prequel.
Oh, right. Good point.
Called Water Force 5.
You didn't mess it up. Correct. There are three control axes, and the other two...
It's not how you spell axes, subtitle.
Question. What is it called when two aircraft almost collide?
A disaster.
A close shave.
A close miss.
Another correct answer.
He's passenger a little mad at that.
With devices yep. To prevent near misses. Question. What is the largest aircraft manufacturer in America?
Is it Access Games? I think it's
Air Force One.
Why are you confused?
Their headquarters is in Seattle, and they also build spacecraft.
That's true. Lockheed Martin is their biggest competitor.
What name is given to
it's Access Games.
Caused by always sitting in the same position.
Peter Pan Syndrome. Stockholm Syndrome.
I mean, at a certain point, you just have to love it.
They kind of give you that one. Like, who would call it Stockholm Syndrome?
Everybody.
It is also called long haul syndrome.
Who calls it long haul syndrome?
That's a good question.
What city is that named after?
During a flight, you should keep moving about and massage your legs.
What city is economy class syndrome named after?
It's economy class Nebraska.
All right.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks.
Like I said at the beginning, anyone can reach this level easily. You have proven that, Mr. Young.
Oh boy.
How did you do?
B plus. I will pass.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Still don't know how you managed to fuck up the easiest ones.
Like I said, they're the two most, they're not the easiest questions. They're the most obscure knowledge of a plane.
Uh-huh. That's what an idiot without an encyclopedia on aircraft dictionaries would say.
Good point.
What?
Although, I gotta say, I will admit nitroglycerin was dumb.
I have no idea.
We're lighting this baby on fire.
We're going down.
That lady in the middle of economy class? She's the one who got all worked up about the squeaking window, right?
So the last clue that we're going to get relates to when we first met Deborah. And she
window.
Said the west side window. The window on the west side. The setting sun on the west side of the west window.
I don't recall any such
we're going to see the sun on the other side of the plane.
Good point.
That and that's supposed to clue you in that you're going north to south instead of south to north.
Yep. Oh boy.
I do like the way that David figures it out, because he sort of starts announcing it to everyone, and nobody knows what the fuck he's talking about.
Of course he does.
And this part is also really touchy. There are a couple points in the game where we have to rub dirt off of surfaces, and it's kind of hard to know when the game thinks it's okay?
Yeah.
What a beautiful sunset. It reminds me of the day I proposed.
Peggy, get down!
Stop
You're gonna
swinging
fall.
In the air. How did you do that?
What if you fall? Like, do a flip.
What are you attached to?
It's like that... She's like Spider-Man. There doesn't have to be anything there. Just whatever.
Little Peggy. I'll find who killed you. I will.
She didn't do a flip.
Nope.
I've collected all the puzzle pieces.
The west side window.
There will be champagne as soon as we arrive in DC.
I'm very sorry, sir. But she wasn't a
woman. I don't know who you are. That's it.
I'm hungry.
This piece of the past has been solved.
I need a burger.
Marshall, are you really sentimental enough to hold on to a pen that can't even write? Unexpected. Most unexpected. You seem quite different from the man I first imagined you to be, but that doesn't mean you're totally free from suspicion.
I told you
the same trick won't work twice.
Damn it!
Is that how you waltz?
The first time for you.
Yes.
I've never waltzed before.
The Fenway Park ticket was a used ticket.
What?
The seat cover pattern is cherry blossom and snow.
I like that Derek.
What are you rambling?
Doesn't know what's happening.
Yep.
And he wouldn't. Like, imagine if somebody started doing this to you.
Right, exactly.
The sun can be seen from the windows on the right side. In other words, the aircraft is flying south.
Explain yourself clearly!
I am David Young, a private detective who also collaborates with the BPD. Now you, Derek Buchanan, I consider you suspicious.
Likewise.
If you
likewise.
Are the one I'm after,
yep.
You're gonna remain heavily involved in my investigation from now on. So let me give you this warning. I'll do whatever it takes to achieve my goal. I'll never give up.
The hell? Just happened.
Even if it means I have.
You're not the only one that thinks that.
So be ready for that. Oh, one other thing. Something I probably ought to mention. According to the BPD files, you get killed while transporting the courier known as Rabbit.
That's not the first time David's actually said that to him. It's one of the first things he said to him.
Yeah.
Hey, you want to find out how that pen got broke?
Yeah, God.
Writes too hard.
I'm going to be killed?
Yes?
No, killed, not keeled.
Antonio Zapatero,
this ain't a ship.
Olivia Jones.
We're not keel hauling
yet. Vanished right in front of my eyes. Literally, vanished. But they didn't vanish at all. They were never on this flight. This isn't the AG Flight 117 of Boston. It's a different aircraft. Heading for Washington. In other words, they didn't vanish. I moved. It must have happened at that moment. I used the broken fountain pen to come further back in time. Feel anything from either one anymore.
David. Why do you shave your beard every day? It was just starting to grow out. It's such a waste.
Little Peggy. What should I do?
Whose glasses?
Well, only one person had glasses.
Damn it.
But if David falls asleep or gets knocked out,
you go back to the couch.
Yup.
Oh.
So that is the end of episode one.
Huh. Pretty interesting.
episode two, we're going to slow things down a little bit.
Oh.
Try to figure out, because we still have a couple missing pieces.
Right.
Now,
look at that sync rate.
How many calories do you think?
20,000. Oh.
6,700 is still a lot.
That is a lot. That's three times a normal man's diet.
In 3 hours of real time.
Yep. Jesus. So you missed a letter.
I did, and it's in a really obvious spot.
Oh.
I believe it appears in the second half of the episode.
Okay.
And I'm... when I say it's in a really obvious spot, I mean it.
It's something really dumb.
It's in the bathroom.
Oh.
You can see it when you dive.
God damn it.
So here's the letter that I missed, right in front of me at least twice during this episode. In this letter, we find out why Clover is so special to Peggy. Seems like she just can't stop finding it.